found a bomb. Make your way to its location. So hello guys and welcome to my channel. Today I'm gonna show you some dirty spots and angles to hold as a defender. This is the first video in what I think will go into two videos, because I have that many spots, but at the moment I can't tell. So I'm gonna do this live speak just to make it easier. But coming in here to skyscraper into like the first angle, it will be from Geisha, and you'll be standing around here and you can hold an angle onto T-Room's window here. This I have to say, this is mainly supposed to be used when the objective is downstairs in kitchen, as you can actually see the bomb is right now. So what you have to do is go over here, ping the middle of the window, go all the way here and just do like this, keep tapping, keep tapping. Then you're gonna have a hole here and you can go over and should be see some bullets here. You're gonna hit them there and here as well. This can be a little bit tricky to get sometimes because of these poles, and you'll not get the same hole every time. But holding this angle, you should, right there, you see a little tiny hole under the window. You can, of course, if you don't feel comfortable looking at that tiny window or tiny angle, then you can, of course, go and make it bigger. But at the moment, this is fine for me. And just saying, if you're watching this on a phone, you might not be able to see it because it's that small. But it makes me a little tiny angle that I can see through that hole. I'm just gonna show you by shooting up the window. Or pinging, actually. If you ping there, you can see my ping actually went all the way out there. And that's how you know you can keep that angle. So as an attacker, and I'm mainly IQ on this map. Oh, fuck, I cannot barricade. So what'll happen is people mainly drone for me, and I can have to push in from this window. So I'll build. I would have been told it's clear, and some guys in Geisha. So I'll just go in here, west the soul, spray a little bit, and then move on. What you have to know about my, like, I spray on this hole just because I see hole. But look here, no bullets at all. So that means in some way, when he jumps in there, if you look fast enough, you will get the angle. Wow. Okay. Like this instead. Then you can get the angle and of course get them faster. What you have to be aware of is that don't do it, like hold this angle 24/7, and be aware of this window. If this gets broken, go away, because then you can get easily shot. So yeah, let's move on to the next spot.
Secure the area. Keep the bombs
protected. Okay, so moving on to the second spot on skyscraper, of course. The bomb is in Tea Room and Karaoke. Not downstairs, but I cannot pick it up here because it's 1-2 already. I've played one round. But when I played mainly Jäger, at some points I have to hold like this part of the building, and that's what Jäger has to do mainly. So what I could do is I removed this window and I went over here and I did like this. I know it's a big hole, but oops.
5 seconds left.
It's a big hole, but that's what make it easier to throw. You might have to do it a little bit lower. I actually have a clip for me, like, first discovering this, like, in a GoFor tournament, and I will put the, like, video of it on the screen as well. I'm sorry again for my slow speaking, but I'm doing this live and it's really confusing as fuck. But you can have a hold on to that angle. What you have to be aware of again is that I'll mainly be in here first, let them drone me out, and then I'll push back, get the drones, so like if I get too many drones they don't have to stop pushing me, and I'll move on back up here and I'll get them when they place a claymore. I got one once, and all that. It's really a nice angle to hold. You have to of course be aware of them not coming from you behind and stuff, and just always be aware of, if you're feeling too precious, just push back. No need to risk your life. So yeah, that was actually a little bit faster as a second spot. So yeah, let's move on to the next one. So yeah, moving on to the third spot. This is actually a funny way that I came across this, and that's from 2 days ago, where somebody did this against me, actually. But what I have seen him do, it like tapped a hole here, and then he could basically just see down a hole. And I'm not normally playing Jäger anymore. I'm playing Pulse main, but and I'm IQ as attack. What I did, I was came up from those stairs. I'm gonna show
down
you the
to
clip.
10 seconds.
And then I had to go into office, and he just one tapped me basically in the head. Like coming from down there, I'll show you. But I'm playing normally with holographic, and for me to see this, I was waiting here. Okay, light is clear. Boom! I was dead. That's how tiny that hole is. Nobody sees that. Like the color of like kind of this. I didn't see it. For me, it's just a black spot. Going around, of course, with ACOG like this, I would see it. Of course, but it's a bit tricky. So yeah, of course, holding this angle is again not something you should do 24/7. You should mainly do it when you know they're on Easters, because it's like you can get pushed here really fast. And Ash, if that door's broken, like an Ash can get in here and get you really, really fast. So yeah, moving on to the next spot. Okay, so moving on to the spot number 5, I think, is one I use mainly. This is like normally when I play Pulse, if they're not heavy droning and pushing, then I will stand up here and play Pulse in the beginning. And as soon as I get called out in CCTV or security or whatever it's called, the room that's up here, I'll move on here and use my Pulse scanner and to get a C4 kill or just basically shoot one through the floor. But if I'm at some point feel like okay, I will get pushed now, then I have found out standing up here on this table, holding an angle this way is really great. People normally don't see you before you can see them, and you can get them really fast. And I play with holographic and I still get them headshots. And if they come in, like sometimes they'll push in the beginning of the match from here, standing in this spot again. It's not a part like they really drone, and you can get them really fast by just shooting them in the back. So sometimes of course I can run through here, but that's just so you can just follow them, and you can of course also hold like this. I really hope this makes sense, because this is a really great spot I like using, and nobody really checks it. Then of course if to hold this is just bonus that I just like reminded. But standing up on this is also a great way to hold an angle to those coming from Talos. So yeah, that was the two spots and a little bonus, I guess, I had for border. So yeah, let's move on to the next map.
Time expires, it's protected.
Okay, so now we are on the third map, and I'm going to show you spot number 5. Yeah, spot number 5. So this is for like defending downstairs laundry and what's the supply room, I think it's called? A and B bump. And normally you want to have control of meeting here, so a great way to do it, or one of the ways that can be used, if you have a Jäger that's good to hold an angle and good with an ACOG,
10 seconds left.
Then he can go up here and he will just start spraying like this, and it needs to be Jäger basically secure. Because like his weapons is that stronger than most of the others' weapons. Like Band could not make these holes. That's just let me get it. So the wall you see out there is basically the wall into classroom, and the door should be right over there. Kind of like, I don't know if I can see it. Oh, I can't. Oh wait. Okay, actually, I'm sorry, I'm getting confused. Yeah, the door is over there, so you can barely see the door. So mainly, like, people will come from a kitchen, and they'll be focusing on the stairs there, but they'll, of course, be then they know this hole is here. But for them to go in here, I will, like, scan it like this, and then I'll see the hole. But for me, as a holographic player, okay, this is hard, but I'll come like this, of course aiming, but get it up there, then I'm dead before I can even get the peak. Only if I know them, I'll maybe get them, I guess. Like this, but I think the Jaeger standing up on those stairs have a way better advantage. It's a great way to hold it. Yeah, and that the way I normally hold it, because I play with whole graphic, is just standing behind those box. Have a little hole here, so I can keep the same angle. But if you have the ACOG, you're much more safe if you stand up here and just hold it like this, because you can hold that doorway. And then if we have enough roamers or like a guy playing here as well, he can hold that door. Then it's really great, because then they'll be focusing on getting him and he just have to hold that door himself. And people, they'll realize he's holding that door, so pushing from that. And then the Jaegers there is like amazing. So yeah, that was the 5th spot. Okay, so moving on to number 6 spot, and the last one in this like series for today. That's for a map you can play in ESL Go 4 and Community Cup. Is as an defender or defending upstairs, you are playing Bandit, and Bandit's reinforcing these two walls. He will have a Jaeger here. This is a little bit tactic as well, but the Bandit, he has to sometimes the band trick these walls because the objective is in here. And when he's doing that, he can hold like
time expires in 10
this
seconds.
Tight angle, and you'll be surprisingly how often people go past it, and he can just get those little picks. I know this was a fast spot, but there's not that much into it. He just has to be aware of bandits during this. So yeah, that was the 2 spots I have for Oregon. And now let's move on to my bonus map that you cannot play in the Go Force and ESL League.
You need to protect the hostage, secure the room.
Okay, so this works as both hostage, I guess, since the hostage is burned down here. Which I didn't know before now, because I normally just play bomb and sometimes for grind secure. But this is about, you will ping this briefcase and you will go down here. Wow. Okay, so normally I think that ping lasts for long, because normally I have time to do this.
Down to 10 seconds.
Fuck's sake.
5 seconds.
Did I do it?
Not located.
Wow, it had to be a little bit lower. We normally just shoot one time, but this actually works, I guess. But it's supposed to be like a little bit lower. But what this works for is like it's tiny little bullet, like the one I showed on board. And my friend also actually showed me this 2 days ago, and he's been using it. I normally don't use it, but he's using it, and he keeps getting them fucking one-tap kills on it. It's like, it's just they come around the briefcase corner, as not people normally do, and just do like this, and he gets them. He even got a fucking Blackbeard like this, and Blackbeard didn't see him. I know now I've made my bullet hole a little bit bigger, but let's go down and see it, how it looks. Cause trust me, it's fucking hard angle to push. And then it works on, I guess now it's both secure, hostage, and bomb, of course. They'll be coming like this, and normally, yeah, I would not see that. I mean, normally people hold this in the beginning and then they'll go down here. And there's a lot of barbed wire you have to be aware of. People come in here and then they are basically always dead by that fucking little hole. People will not see that. That's a really great tight angle you hold, and you can see what I saw basically was around here. You can see my bullet hole there actually. So yeah, this is really amazing hole, and I'm really glad my friend showed me that. And he's been like, yes, I know this for like 2 days, and he's been getting ton of kills every fucking single time we play this map. So yeah, that was the first bonus of 2. So let's move on to the next map.
Rescue attempt is a go.
Okay, so the second bonus map is actually for an attacker. And what happens is that normally when playing on canal, this is no matter where the objective is, it just has to be in that building, east building. Apparently this is the tactical realism, but what happens is, I have my drone here. Oh no, I don't have it, but I normally place my drone like here. Oh, okay, no, like up there. And then somebody hold it for me. And then they tell me, okay, this is either free on bridge or there's a guy standing in model, something like that. And in case a guy is standing in model, what I like to do, I normally push in with Ash. So Ash, he will either start droning if the drone's dead or stop pushing. So what I do, I shoot open this window. Wow, did will it go well? Oh, I shoot up this window and then I can hold like this angle. And what you can see for this is I can actually see around this corner. So as soon as the guy is like, if I normally play here as well and try holding bridge, but what I'll normally do, I'll be flying like this and I'll not get that. And yeah, this is the spot that I normally use, and for first time in, I've tried it one time, a guy used it against me and it was Jackal. And even though I knew he was there and I was standing here, he got me, cause I tried pre-fire and everything, but first time I pre-fired, he got me instantly. Because there was like an Ash on the bridge as well, so I pre-fired the Ash and like I saw he was over there and I pre-fired and he got me. Boom. So the next one, what I did, I took an ACOG, a Shaker, and I laid down here. This is the way to count it if you know they're doing it. I was just waiting for him basically to open up the window, and I got him. So yeah, in that way it can be countered, but normally people don't. And that's the great thing about this. So yeah, that was my second bonus for a map you cannot play on yourself. And that was actually the whole video I had for today. So yeah, I'll of course be making a second part of this, but at the moment I'll try to edit this and then the second part will come later, I guess. I really hope you enjoyed it and will get some nice response, and I'm sorry for my live speak, it's not normally going as fast as I wanted to, but yeah, that's life. Life sucks. Peace out. We're loving and hating and making scenes. Now we just see everything we believe.